Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class I will be dealing with the issue chagos archipelago. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very important for political science optional students. Now what is the dispute around this chagos archipelago? First of all, we need to know about that, and secondly we need to know about how India is involved in this archipelago dispute. Now as far as Chagos archipelago is concerned, it is in Indian Ocean. This archipelago, it has an important island in the form of Diego Garcia. Now Diego Garcia is a military base of United States of America, and this base has been leased to United States of America by United Kingdom. Now the England has given this Diego Garcia base on lease to United States of America. Recently this lease has been extended by 20 years, so till 2036 United States of America will have this Diego Garcia island as its military base in the Indian Ocean. Now the dispute is between the Mauritius government and between United Kingdom. Now what is this dispute about? This dispute has begun when Mauritius got its independence. Now Mauritius got its independence in year 1968. Now when it got its independence in 1968, British, as per the decolonization rules, should have left all the islands that belong to Mauritian government and should have vacated all of them. But this was not the case, because in 1967 British had formed BIOT. It's very important to understand this BIOT. This is British Indian Ocean Territory. So they have formed this British Indian Ocean Territory, the British. Now this British Indian Ocean Territory was formed by involving the islands that belong to Seychelles and the other ones belonging to Mauritius. So all these islands were clubbed and BIOT was formed. But in year 1968, Mauritius got its independence from England. And like I have told you, as per decolonization, it was supposed to evacuate all these. It's a responsibility to leave all these islands, but this was not the case. British kept Diego Garcia Island under its suzerainty. Now why it kept it under its suzerainty? It kept it under its suzerainty because it wanted to have an influence in the Indian Ocean. Now here comes the role of India. India wants that this entire Indian Ocean should become a peace zone. It should remain a zone of peace. It should not have any kind of influence of the foreign powers. So India is basically interested in a peaceful Indian Ocean. So India's main interest is that the foreign powers like USA, like United Kingdom, like China, they should not be asserting their role in Indian Ocean. So from the Indian perspective, it is very important that the Mauritius government should have access to this Diego Garcia island. Now Mauritian government is also interested in internationalizing this issue. Mauritian government wants this issue to be placed in International Court of Justice. Mauritian government also wants this issue to be discussed as per the principle of UNCLOS, United Nations Convention on the Law of Sea. Mauritian government also wants that the England should give back the land to the Mauritian government, because as per Mauritius, these islands belong to them. They are an integral part of Mauritius. Now, India is actually in a dilemma whether it should be supporting Mauritius or it should not be supporting Mauritius, because presently the Diego Garcia Island is under the suzerainty of United States of America, because it has been leased by United Kingdom to USA till 2036. Now, in case USA will give away its rights over this Diego Garcia Islands, the Mauritian government is not a strong government. It can come under influence of China. Now, in that case, China will have influence over Diego Garcia, and China will be able to fulfill its strategy of encirclement and containment. What it will do, it will encircle Indian Ocean. It will try to contain India's march in the Indian Ocean and India's dream of engendering Indian Ocean as a peaceful ocean will not be fulfilled. Now, the question that can be asked in your mains examination, critically analyze how the Chagos archipelago issue is important from India's perspective. Or another question could be like, critically analyze how this Chagos archipelago dispute can be resolved. Now, if you want to read more on this, you can visit brainyias.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainy IAS. You can find this application from Google Play Store and from App Store. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.